from what we're going through right now, those who can make quick decisions and know where their money is will be able to capitalize, and they'll be set up for success for years to come.
Welcome to our second episode of the Waking Up to Win podcast with Realty One Group. Our objective is to be your one resource and voice of both inspiration and reality during trying, somewhat chaotic, yet constantly changing times. As the situation evolves, we're committed to bringing you the industry's best and to discuss topics that bring value to you as we move ahead one day at a time. Today, we introduce you to our own COO, Mr. Mike Clear. Mike, welcome.
Hey, thank you, Mark. Good to be here.
So, Mike, you've been leading our troops at Realty One Group for a little over 3 years, yet you have vast experience in the industry. Tell us a little bit about both your experience and your role here at Realty One Group.
Sure. So I got started in home service or the real estate industry in 1999 when I was recruited to become the chief operating officer of a home warranty company. So my customer were real estate agents, real estate brokers. So in that role, I was leading that group, and we were placing home warranties, doing home service throughout the United States. And that evolved over a 17-year career in home services, always focused on the real estate agent, the real estate broker, and the whole industry. I then, a little over 3 years ago, Kuba recruited me to come over to Realty One Group. And I've been running the organization with Kuba and with all the talented people on our team since then. So, we have our brokerage business, we have our franchise business, we have an escrow business, and we have a title business, soon to be a mortgage. So that keeps me busy and running kind of the overall P&Ls of all those organizations with our great division presidents and Pat Kelly, Vinny Tracy, and Tara Johnson. And we have a lot of fun. We try to do great work for our customers, the real estate professionals out there. And every day we try to wake up to win.
Mike, give us a little insight as to what the professional realtor should be doing today financially to be prepared for success. And if it's okay, we'd like to look at this from two perspectives. One, today, what needs to happen today to ensure success tomorrow? And then two, the after. How does today's professional prepare to dominate the market in the boom that is sure to follow?
Okay, well, first off, real estate professionals are 1099 independent contractors. So you're running your own business. So you have to run it like a business. It's different than if you're a salaried worker or a W-2 worker where you have to budget your household. So I believe it's important that anybody that runs a business runs their business like a true business and has a profit and loss statement and understands the basics of a P&L. You should know what a balance sheet is, but that's not as critical as understanding your profit and loss statement, and your cash flow. In any business, cash is king. So what you want to do is you want to make sure you're setting up financially the right system. And there's so many good tools out there, whether it's QuickBooks or Mint or all these online tools that you can use very easily that are not expensive to keep track of all your stuff, because you have to know where you are at any given point in time in order to make the right decisions, pounce at the right time on the opportunities, and deliver on those results. So I think financially, that's the first part. Be a business owner and make sure you have a P&L, you understand your cash flow. Now, the other thing is you still are running a household. You're still running your own personal thing. So then it comes into budgeting of expenses in your own household. So outside of the business, it's important that you know money management. And all of us have to worry about money management, and some are better than others. Throughout my life, I've been great at it, and sometimes, and then I fall victim to doing what's fun for the family. So I'm willing to often spend a little more than I should because it's fun and it's an experience. But you have to make those decisions yourself. And there's tons of resources out there available, whether it's Dave Ramsey or I mentioned Mint or QuickBooks. There's a lot of advisors that you can follow. I think it's important that you follow your own one that fits your style. There's no one right way to do it. It's whatever works for you and clicks with you. But try to find a system and then stick to the system. If I said, well, I absolutely think you need to follow this person or that person, that would be bad advice. It's go find whichever one that you kind of resonates with you and then go do it. It's no different than exercising. Some people run, some people lift weights, some people cross train. It kind of whatever works for you, as long as you're getting it done and finding success, that's what's most critical. So that's, let's say, the base or the foundation of the home or the cornerstone. If you don't have those things in place, it's hard for me to answer question two, Mark, which is, how do you prepare to dominate the market when the boom comes next? Well, you need that base first. And if you have that base, then it's easy to weather out any downturn and then prepare for the upturn. So I would say that get that base done, get that foundation built. And then as the market comes out, you're prepared to invest intelligently towards that. You have the right business plan, you have the right tools. And, you know, we can get into more of that later, Mark, you know, if you want me to expand more on a business plan type aspect of things.
I'm out. What I hear you saying is that a budget is important.
Absolutely. There's two budgets that you have to have as a business owner, a real estate professional, your business budget and then your personal budget. So it's sometimes tougher on the real estate community because they have to be managing both. And one thing that we have, the benefit that I have in running companies with Kuba, is we have Gary Fabian, who's our CFO, and then I have a controller and John, a director of FP&A, and Paulo. Like, we have great, smart resources behind us to make sure I have all the answers I need and I have people crunching it. Well, when you're running your independent business, you don't have that. You kind of have to wear all those hats. So it's important that you don't have to be an accountant. You don't have to be that type of person. You just have to follow the basics and keep it simple. But it's critically important to know what that budget is, to know how you make money, and to know what type of money you need to spend personally to ensure that you keep your money. Because it's not always about what you make. It's what you spend. It's what you keep. So that's critically important in how you run that.
And even though we're nearing the end of the first quarter, it's not too late to develop a budget?
No, I mean, there's never too late. Any time is a good time. Businesses, we are redoing our planning constantly. So we'll start planning for 2020. We started planning in September. So we started laying out how we think 2020 is going to act. So we go through all that thing, and then new stuff happens in the world that we're going through right now. You throw that out and you start rebudgeting again. You know, you shift. So we're constantly budgeting. So it's never too late to start, and it should be constant. You don't need to overkill it. I'm not trying to say that you have to spend 20 hours a week on this. It's not something like that. If you keep up with it, it's very easy and you'll know the answers. I don't know if you guys have ever watched the show Shark Tank. How many times are you shocked that people don't know their basic numbers? And what are the people trying to get them to do? To just tell them the basics of their business. So you have to be able to know those basic numbers of how much are you spending on advertising? If you have a team, how much are your employee costs? What's your facilities expense if you rent an office? All those things are just basics that if you know those off the top of your head, you'll be able to make fast decisions. Because as the market rebounds from what we're going through right now, those who can make quick decisions and know where their money is will be able to capitalize, and they'll be set up for success for years to come.
And I that's great, Mike. And I think what I also heard you say in there is the importance of having a business plan as well. Do you think that it's still an opportune time for agents to put together a business plan if they haven't already done so?
Yeah, I think it's a great time. And I mean, hey, Mark, that's what you and Kathy Baker and One.U are all about, is helping people build that business plan. And there's countless hours of training in our One.U for people to listen to and get the how to build a business plan. So I'll have people reach out to me and say, I don't know how to build a business plan. Well, there's ways to do it that they would teach you in grad school, but it's pretty basic. A business plan starts out with kind of what's my current situation. It defines what you are in your market, defines your market, defines who you compete against. You know, it lays out kind of what your strategy is to go compete against the people that you're up against in your market. It outlines your numbers and financials and kind of what you want to plan around that. And then you're setting out a strategy for, here's how I believe I can win. And it organizes your thoughts in a way that you kind of got the playbook. Imagine going into a football game. I'm a football guy, but so I always relate back to that. And you didn't know what your plays were. And you just kind of went in the huddle and say, well, you go this way, you go that way. That wouldn't work. It works in the backyard pickup game, but it doesn't work in a real game. So you have to know your playbook, and your playbook is your business plan. And I think we have great resources in One.U, and we have great resources with you, Mark, and Kathy Baker, to make sure that we're there to help people build that. And our and our management team is there, our brokers in our offices, our franchise owners and their brokers, they're all fairly skilled at this and can help people, you know, kind of write this and develop that, because we want everyone in our network to win.
That's great, Mike. And we do have an amazing resource for that. At Realty One Group, we have the 2020 Vision Plan. We launched it in Q4 of 2019, having no idea how valuable this would be to our network. Yet today, with your insight, it's really brought it home. And you can find it in 1.u just by searching for business plan. Now, Mike, what else would you suggest? Other than what we've discussed, what one action will make a difference on the other side of this, you know, when the boom hits?
Well, I mean, that's the million-dollar question. I wish we all had a crystal ball to know exactly what that looked like and when it was going to hit. But I would say right now, we all have a little time while we're in our homes or, you know, trying to get as much work as we can get done remotely, to get educated, to train yourself on this budget. It's basic. There's never a one-hit wonder when it comes to business basics. You have to put in the work. And the work right now is educate yourself on kind of basic, you know, how to build a budget, how to build a P&L. There's tons of tools out there to make it easy and get the business plan written. Know how you're going to attack that market depending on what hits. The one thing that I've been, you know, talking about with the franchise owners this week is the other thing that might be the one thing. I call it the break glass plan. So, you know, that you always see the sign, in case of emergency, break glass. So it's always good to have a plan like that, you know, somewhere in your file that says, OK, if this happens, here's the action plans I'm going to take. So everybody's break glass plan is different because everybody has a different set of circumstances in their personal life and their professional life. So when you find yourself in something like the situation we're in right now, where we're homebound, or, you know, we've been in California here, we're at a stay at home order, you know what that plan looks like. Break the glass, bring that plan out and stay calm and persevere through it. The one thing I can say is if you're properly prepared and plan, you've got more confidence than everybody else, because while everybody else is like, I don't know what to do. You know exactly what to do and you can lead with calm. And I think that's the biggest thing in anything we face in life is staying calm and being prepared to get through things. We're never 100% prepared, but a little bit of preparation goes a long way.
Mike, this has been both informative and insightful. Thank you for your contribution and guidance on what will be an amazing recovery.
Hey, no problem. Good luck, everyone.
As a business owner, and remember, as an independent contractor, you are. If you'd like more information on planning and managing your business, please visit 1.u and subscribe to these modules. Simply search for Managing Your Money and Profit by Forward Coaching, Monthly Visit Your Money List by Forward Coaching, and Managing by Henry Mintzberg. And remember, friends, together we will achieve greater success faster.